not very good at games. I like playing them. Let's append the pixel transparency preset.
Ooh.
Looking cool. I think this looks kind of cool, man. Hey, RetroArch users. I'm here to share with you a brand new shader that I created specifically for Game Boy Color games, but it also looks good on Game Boy Advance games. It's called Pixel Transparency. I previously did the Game Boy Dot Matrix full screen shaders and the Game Boy Color Dot Matrix shaders. And I really liked how that captured kind of the nostalgic feel of a device that never existed, which was a Dot Matrix Game Boy Color. But what I also kind of missed was that authentic Game Boy Color experience. So this kind of goes the other direction and tries to simulate a real Game Boy Color type of screen. Now, one of my peers in the shader community named Fishku, he already did about a year and a half ago a great shader called Authentic GBC. And on your handhelds, there's a preset called Authentic GBC Fast under the handhelds folder. And that's an amazing shader that actually recreates the subpixels of a Game Boy Color. But there's one big problem with all of these grid shaders, and that is the original devices did not display white pixels. So what actually happened on the white pixels and even the lighter colored pixels is that the backing material of the display would show through because these displays did not have a backlight. That's why you had to hover under a lamp or use the worm light, something like that. But what this means is that on modern displays, games that took advantage of that transparent background are eye-searingly white. Like, I encourage any of you to play Pokemon Gold or Crystal on a modern device and see what it does to your eyes, okay? All the backgrounds that were transparent now appear as white. Some emulators have tried to fix this by yellowing the background. I think the Nintendo Switch 2 online actually yellows all of the whites, which is sort of a solution. But another solution is the dark color filter in Gambate, but that kind of dims the whole color effect. I was not satisfied. So I created the Pixel Transparency Shader. Let's take a look. Okay, this is my RG477M. I love this thing. This is a metal handheld. Ooh, it's a beautiful thing, I will tell you. I want to jump here into RetroArch. And let's go back and pull up a game. This is Pokemon Puzzle Challenge. I love this game. Now, here we are without any type of shaders. Okay, so this is just raw content here. Oh, they're so cute. Okay, now let's open up a shader. By the way, the latest release just came out of RetroArch about a couple weeks ago. Within the shaders menu, you can hit the Y button to make the background transparent or opaque for testing shaders. So let's open up what is a great shader, the Authentic GBC shader. So this is by Fishku. Now this, you can see, gives you a beautiful grid. Let me just turn up the brightness. Yeah, it looks like a Game Boy Color screen. But again, the problem is we're backlit. So them whites are white, I tell you. Look at all these, wow, that is some white whites. I was not happy with that. The Game Boy Color Dot Matrix shader kind of solved this issue, but I wanted to kind of take that out of there and be able to apply it to any grid shader. So you go to Append Preset. We can go down to Pixel Transparency. And now we can see it's very subtle, but those whites, they're not white anymore. So take a look here. Here is the shader off, eye-searingly white, on, off. So by default, it's a very subtle effect, and you also get a nice drop shadow. Now you can crank up the transparency amount. So we can set that to like 40. And now we're really cooking with gas here. That's a little bit too much, to be honest. Let's go back down to 30. Now we can set off, on, off, That's cool, right? That looks pretty stinking good. Let's go into marathon mode. Actually, we're going to challenge, continue. Okay, now there, look at that, boom, boom. I just think it looks really cool. Now we can, let's take this back down to 20, and then you can even change where the transparency is applied. So right by default, only bright pixels. You can go to all pixels. Now look at that, that's interesting. So authentic GBC, authentic GBC with pixel transparency, all pixels. It looks pretty cool, man. Let's get my Pikachu out. Oh yeah, here we go. Gosh, it just, to me, looks so much better than those ice ring whites. So again, this is all pixels. We can go to bright pixels only. I like that because it preserves the color, but you still see how that's applying that to the whites and giving you that nice subtle drop shadow that kind of simulates what the light would shine on these pixels. There would be some shadowing. And that just looks so good to me. Dang, man. So we're augmenting that shader. So the first pass is the authentic GBC fast, and then we're putting this over it. So look at that. This is the bright mode. Now you can even do white only pixels. So you can go to transparent pixels white, and you can do transparent amount, and this will only do the white pixels. You can set the white pixel detection threshold. So 1, nothing. By default, it's 90. You can even boost the white transparency separately and get some pretty wild effects here. The colors might be a little harsh at that point, and you can filter them colors accordingly. Pump that up to 10. Not enough. I like keeping everything toggleable so you can compare really easily. Okay, so the white mode to me is, it's a little extreme. I like bright or all. I think all with transparency amount 20 is just a really cool effect. It does affect the colors a little more. So you can go to bright and then increase that if you want to preserve the colors, but take the edge off those whites. Now what's cool is you can use this with any grid shader. So let's load up another one of my favorite grid shaders, LCD Grid V2. Okay, here we are. So off. Oh my Lord. Oh, turn that back on. You can't play this without shaders. I don't care who you are, man. Shaders look better. That argument has been decided. So turn that on. Now we got a lovely grid here. This is one of my favorite grids, LCD Grid V2. But you can see them whites are burning my eyes. Okay, that's a little much. Them whites are burning my eyeballs. So what we're gonna do is append the preset. We're gonna go to pixel transparency. Boom. This grid is a lot more forgiving. I noticed that authentic GBC results in artifacting sometimes. This you can run again. We're not integer scaled here. So like my pixels are not balanced and we're still getting some great grid results. So again, this is the default. It's a very subtle effect, but I think it's enough to make a big difference. Off, on. Let's crank it up to 30. Look at that. Off, on. Ooh, let's go back down to 20 transparency amount and go to all pixels. Ooh, now we're looking. To me, I love this because this is just, it just feels like how I remember it. Like I don't, the pick, first of all, nobody was seeing the real colors on those displays. By the way, I have ghosting enabled in the core settings, and I have color correction enabled in the Gambate settings. And otherwise, it would look really, really terrible. So, off, on. Now again, the all mode affects the colors, so here we go. Let's load up another game. Pokemon Polished Crystal, baby. This is a great version of Pokemon Crystal with a lot of quality of life features. Okay, that is some white whites. Pokemon really used the whites to be intended to be transparent. Here's a great example, the battle screen. I don't know about you, but when I was a child, I'm 33 years old now, I don't remember them whites being that white. So, okay, let's figure out the shaders here. We're going to load LCD Grid V2. Okay, still burning my eyeballs. Oh my gosh. Oh wow. We're fighting a bug with a bug. Wow, what the heck? And then I need to go to a Poke Center. Geodude. Okay, now let's append pixel transparency. Boom! Look at that. Look at that. You get a nice drop shadow effect. Them whites are the edges to, and I just died. Okay. The edge is taken off. Let's put out this other bean sprout. Okay. Again. Off. On. Big difference. Let's increase that transparency to 30. We're getting kind of crazy with that, but off. On. We are saving our eyeballs. You can even adjust the tint. Off. You know, I like it. The Game Boy Pocket style color. Bring that back down to 20 and then all. I love that with all. I mean, look at that. Kind of warms the whole image. You get that nice transparency effect. You can even do whites only if you want. And experiment with different white boost modes. You can get some crazy looks here. But the main thing is like all mode, bright mode. I think that just looks so good. Okay. Fully paralyzed. Get me out of here. This is ridiculous. I'm not very good at games. I like playing them. Pokemon. Okay. Oh, this is a great example. Is this screen. Okay. Here's what it looks like without pixel transparency. Lord help me. That is eye searing. Again, the developers intended this to be transparent. So we're playing this on modern displays, burning our retinas. It doesn't even look like it used to. Now we turn on that pixel transparency. Ooh, that's just all mode, bright mode. So bright mode is default, still a lot better, but I like the all mode, man. That is interesting to me. Just looks so cool. Look at this. So again, pixel transparency off, on, off, on. This is all mode, bright mode. Yeah, I mean, the bright mode preserves the colors for sure. That's another critique I've heard of the Game Boy Color dot matrix, is the colors are affected a lot. So you can do bright mode and just take the edge off those whites. But I like this mode. Look at that. It looks so good. Here, we'll go to the badges screen because I think that always looks cool. Yeah, look at that. Hey, off, on. It's night and day. I mean, come on. I can't go back. I can't go back after this. And this would be awesome for all of you people with an iNeo Pocket DMG or the upcoming iNeo Pocket Vert or Retroid Pocket Classic. This is a great effect on those devices. So cool. So cool. Now, we can even go over to some Game Boy Advance. Let's go to Apatris, which is the best version of Tetris ever invented by man. It's not even licensed. So here we are with the raw pixels. It just looks so bad. My goodness, I don't know. How do you people play this? How do you just raw dog your games like this? Okay, so now we'll go into loading the LCD grid V2. Now, you know what? Why don't we change up LCD 1X? We could do that. So now we have a nice grid effect. This is perfectly acceptable. But for some crazy effects, we'll put pixel transparency again, appending it. Look at that. Now we got this kind of crazy blur thing going on. Ooh. So again, this works as the last pass of any grid shader. This is just kind of like, I don't even know what's going on here because we're just getting into some crazy effects territory now. The Game Boy Advance did not look like this, obviously. Look at this, is all mode. There's that depth effect. I think this looks kind of cool, man. Like, again, so we're gonna turn this off, on. It gives it that sort of depth. Like the pieces look almost 3D, and to me, again, we're entering into imaginary device territory here, but I think it just looks cool as heck. And we can go back to bright mode only. That does look cool too. I don't really like LCD 1X. Let's load back up my favorite, which is LCD grid V2. Append the pixel transparency preset. Now we're cooking. Yeah, that looks smoother to me. If you haven't played Apatris, you need to go play it immediately. If you're a Tetris fan, even if you're not, this game is like really cool. So all bright. It just looks really cool. Game & Watch Gallery 2, one of my favorite games for the Game Boy Color. Look at this. Again, the developers did not intend these pixels to be white. So let's load up this time Authentic GBC Fast. Shout out to FishKoo. Okay, great, but then pixels are still too white. Let's append the pixel transparency preset. Ooh, looking cool. Okay, that's without it. So, okay, with it, without, with, without. That's the default. We go into all mode. Even better. Pew, pew. I feel like that is so cool. Let's go play Parachute. Yeah, that to me, it's just looking great. Pew, off, on. You get, I mean, look at Mario. Look at the shadow there. I think of Bob Wolf when I do Mario. Mario! Okay. Look at it. I mean, the shadow with that, the boat, the flying boat. That's a little weird now that I think about it. Okay, all. So this is only targeting bright pixels. We're preserving that color. We can increase that transparency amount. If you want, a little bit of great artifacting. And that preserves the color. So that's the default. It's just bright mode. At 20, so it's even more subtle. You can even adjust like drop shadow location. This is drop shadow 3. It's a lot more subtle. I decided to ship it with 4 because that effect is more pronounced, but you can adjust the offset, even the shadow opacity, or no shadows at all, but I really like the shadow effect. Let's take a look at just white only mode. This uses transparency, or the white pixel detection threshold. So that's a 1. So it ships at 90. So that carves out the background, but you can go crazy and just start carving out the whole freaking image here. But 90 is great. And then you can just control the transparency of even just the white elements, which kind of creates a unique effect here. A little intense. That's where the color harshness filter can come in. Ooh, that's way too... It's by default. I'm going to fix that. You see the difference? Beep, boop. Okay, anyway. Let's go to a different game. Let's do some chef. There we go. That's looking great. This is the defaults. On. Off. On. This is bright mode. All mode. I like that. That just looks so good. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think about this shader. You can go to settings, update Slang Shaders, and then it's in the handheld folder called Pixel Transparency. Also in the presets folder under Pixel Transparency, there's going to be like 5 presets with all of your favorite grid shaders already all pre-setted up. So you can just load that in over a Game Boy Color game or a GBA game if you're feeling adventurous. Hope to see you soon. I've heard your feedback. I'm working on Gameboy.matrix shaders for GLSL that'll work with Linux devices and bring that shader experience to a whole new range of devices. Thanks for watching. Subscribe. Bye.